Welcome everyone, my name is Benoît Kellin. In this short video, I'm going to show you how you can get real value by combining process mining and automation with one unique solution, Blue Prism Process Intelligence. So let's take a real life example. As a recent sales manager, you're working for a major fragrance and perfume manufacturer and reseller. Your company is a leader in the domain and has grown by acquisition mainly. However, you are more and more challenged by other players. And that becomes quite tough to get that leadership position in the market. So that's the reason why your direction decides to focus more on the customer experience. And the first obvious challenge is to improve the order to cash process. But how? Where to start? Good news, you know someone at Blue Prism. You just call him about your concern. Of course I can help you, he said. This is how Blue Prism will work with you. First of all, we need to understand how really your process is managed. We also may need to understand how your employees are working. Then we'll automate what could be automated based on what we have discovered previously. So are you ready? Everything starts after collecting the data. But gathering the data is always a big challenge. Most of the time, you have to merge data from different systems and to do a lot of transformation. In our case, we have two files from two different systems. So first, we need to merge them by using a common field. Look at that, how it's simple to manipulate the data with Blue Prism. Everything is totally graphical, no need to do some SQL code. The business analyst can now work without coding or asking any help from the IT department. Now look at the heaven field. Apparently we have some inconsistency here. This heaven should be named in a different way, so let's change that. With simple clicks, we can do a lot of data transformation and see the results. Now we are happy with the data, we can start the analysis with Blue Prism Process Intelligence. To analyze a process, we just need three informations. A timeline identifier, here we'll use the order ID. An event identifier, which is in fact a step into the process, and a timestamp. So let's drag and drop the field as it's requested and load the data. This is the order to cache process definition. In fact, this is the ideal way to manage that process. We name this way the happy path, because most of the time things doesn't happen like that. So let's see what happens in reality. By a single click, you can see in this animation how your process is really managed. It's quite far from the happy path, right? Indeed, you have many paths, many exceptions your business users are using to manage an order. So let's take a look on these different paths. Oh, this is your happy path. We can select only the compliance processes. Hopefully, these compliance processes take less than 10 days to be managed. Now, let's have a look on the other ones. If we look at their duration, we can see that some orders take more than 10 days. Let's drill down again. Definitely, the stock management seems to be a hot point. Now, let's take a deeper look in these orders. This view displays all the barred orders per line. We can also see all the details from each order. We can also focus on a specific order step. Here, we want to understand why the stock management takes so long. We filter the order with several stock checks. The bottleneck view displays the different metrics between the process steps. Look at the stock check. It takes in average 27 hours to be managed. If it took 20 hours instead, we would save more than 2,000 hours. That's huge, isn't it? I think we know where to investigate now. But we need more detail on how our business user manage the stocks. and we don't have this information in our system. So we need a different approach, as we should understand how the user are really working. Let me introduce the task mining approach. This approach provides insight about how your business user really works. To do that, the task mining server gathers all the information from the user desktops and aggregate all these different ways of working to provide a global overview. This is how you configure the task mining server. You can specify the application you want to monitor and the ones you don't. You can also specify some mask and manage the privacy. For example, when a user types his email, another inventory will be recorded. These are the monitored desktops. Let's record a session now. You can see these two screens, two different ways of checking the stocks. As the company has grown by acquisition, we have to manage several warehouses and several applications. Sometimes a user cannot log into all the stock applications. So he asks to his colleague and waits for the answer. And that can take a while. Now we have recorded the business user work. Let's have a look on the result into Blue Prism Process Intelligence. You can see here the amount of time spent on each screen. But more interesting, you can see all the different paths the user took to do this task. Why not doing an automate from what has been recorded? This one seems to be the best one. We can now simply export this way of working as a Blue Prism process or as a specification document. We have now exported a part of the process, but we may need to do some modification in it. So we launch Blue Prism Capture and import the previous task. This is exactly the task recorded previously by Task Mining. So we can now make some change to have a real enterprise process. We can group the steps like that. We can also remove some of those. And we can also add new steps and interaction just in single clicks like that. We can also add new decisions and conditions here. And if needed, record another new branch at any step. Now we export our work to a Blue Prism skeleton or a process document definition. After delivering the automate in production, it makes sense also to monitor and see the outcomes. And to do that, we can use again Blue Prism Process Intelligence. First of all, we need to be alerted when a process takes more than 10 days to be managed. So we can create easily a query to check that. We just select the first and last steps and the maximum duration like this. Then we just save the query. Now, by using the native alerting capabilities, we just have to select the query and specify the type of alert. You can send an SMS or one launching another Blue Prism digital worker to manage the problem. we can also create and follow some KPIs. Good news! After doing this automation, you reach your goal. But more than just achieving this goal, you have also improved your monitoring capabilities and saved many hours of work. So why not moving forward again and investigating more into your process? The Blue Prism team are here to help you to automate better. So why not trying with your process now? I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any question or concern, don't hesitate to reach out.